I am in charge with projects in the National Library, so I'm very interested in how each of you developed your project to, and how you keep your audience close these days. And this is why Adriana asked me to be here near her. I would like to begin by saying a few words about our meeting today. I will start with the coffee, of course, because we have a sharing cafe, so I suppose all of you have a coffee. If not, please take one. This is the first technical issue. Take a coffee. Then, please stay on mute, and if you want to say something, please write on us on the chat, and we will unmute you, or you will unmute, but let's communicate on this issue, because we don't want to we want to understand each other and not to talk all together. Or raise hand. But I think it's better to write on the chat first. I will start by presenting the members of the panel. I only say your names and the institution. And after that, I will give you three questions, let's say, to answer while presenting your project. First is Anca Pop from the County Library in Cluj. Then is Alina Mihaela Nicola from County Library in Bălcea. After that is Mr. Ovidioana from Progress Foundation, Ioana Prihana from ANBPR, and Maria Kovac from Volume Association. As I said, I will give you, I will like to speak as little as possible because I want to give you much space to present your project. So I will give you the question. What we are all interested in. How can libraries connect citizens and boost the civic participation, and how you did it? Which are the challenges in creating bridges between libraries, civil society, and communities? And how you see the future of public libraries in the actual context, which we think will last longer than we expected. Those things, we don't want to answer, of course, each of your opinion is welcome, but please emphasize these aspects while presenting your project. So, Anca, please start.
Hello, I'm happy to be here today, and I'm happy to be with people preoccupied by library and social problems nowadays. I'm sure that public libraries will always, almost now in crisis, together with people, and we'll support them on their activities and all efforts for community. If I'm allowed, I'm sharing my screen with a presentation about programs, volunteer programs, most of all. I'm working on country library, but I'm coordinating volunteers since 2014, and I'm working with people by all the ages, almost on teams, with teams. I may start the presentation. is seen now. Everything okay? Octavian Mogoka County Library is always in the middle of people. Every public library is always in the middle of people. Since almost 100 years, Octavian Goga is trying to develop good services for citizens. I'm sure in Cluj and in our country will not stop today because this corona crisis or any crisis will be. The structure of my presentation is about library doing partnership in community and of course for the member of community. I talk about a volunteer program that I assume is a kind of agora, a point of meeting between people's need and the success attend the problems. Activity meetings before and after crisis, the change that we are supporting on, and changes that will accept the progress. We must improve librarians' abilities, adaptability, in order to improve the life of readers and the service users. Now we on volunteer programs and not only we are working together with people, together with NGOs, with institutions, and for the member of community. Now the connection between library and different organizations in Cluj are a lot with senior centers. Centers, foundation, organization, but centers which belong to City Hall, with schools, with universities foundation, Babeș-Bolyai University nowadays, and medical centers. Those partnerships are taking for a long time, 1-2 years, and another partnership we are doing occasionally. We organize events like Human Library Living in the Same Universe. It's an event that we are doing it since 2015. And we, of course, use a partner, different partners in every year. First year, so we work with a Jewish organization. We had human library. We had books. People affected by Holocaust. Another time we had survivors from bad diseases. So we change when we need, when situation asks our partner. This year, for example, we had an organization, Desire, I guess, because Human Library was with living problems people. So we made agreement in a lot of organizations. In library, we had an evolution on that program. This program is named Get Involved and Give, Be a Volunteer. We connect people in any way is possible. This program started from the Shelf Meets Initiative developed by Provobis National Resource Center for Volunteers in 2014. Year by year, we improved and this program was growing until last year. This year is a year of reinventing everything, reinventing the way we have activities, the way we approach people. The first mission of program, the Provobis program was in collaboration with the Libraries Association and the BPRM, and was about to develop programs with volunteers in libraries, in public libraries. We continued and, like I said, the program grow every year. If, first of all, we had to create small libraries for people in public places, like this in the picture. Then we made courses, English, Japanese, guitars for seniors that living in their care and support center, and another senior from another center had a place for spending time for learn, for sustain the concept lifelong learning. After that, we start to our labs, our technique labs. We have robotic labs, course of drawing, homework support, and our volunteers are involving in open air activities too. Also, we are reading in hospitals for kids. Corona crisis is not the end, it's the change. We change the way we work, but we, of course, we grow to use the virtual space in volunteer activities, and we are using the virtual space in activities with librarians too. Digital librarians are nowadays a sine qua non condition. We are going to put online even the Battle of the Books for seniors with adults from the center number one of this project is a partner since 5 years. We are preparing our educative projects with classes. Like I said, we have agreements with a lot of schools and are preparing right now to send invitation for our projects with schools made by Zoom or Teams or Google Meet or anyway, on virtual world. The possibility to extend the public area is an opportunity in this kind of activities because beneficiaries can be from any place. Not only from Romania or not only from Cluj for now, are less limited. We are fixing meetings in virtual space, so from this reason can be more easier. At least we have volunteers young and very habilitated to use the internet or those tools. They create, we create chats, Facebook groups, games for all ages, and we use forums. In the work with volunteer, we had use all the time chats. For example, if we had to organize lessons, English lessons, I create a chat with a volunteer that could do this and all people involved. One meeting that we had this year was in the time of Teens Day, we had a meeting about drugs with preventive associations, and we had this summer on holiday program informatic lessons. IT, of course, the program, the IT programs, the technical area is the first to survive and grow in this time. C++ is a course in the time of school year. In the summer this year, we had JavaScript. If Corona wouldn't be, maybe we could do those lections here in our library. If we live new times, we approach new rules. Handmade, made with a few people, with social distance, with 2 or 4 meters between. Robotics, we use robotics too. Even this year, those pictures are from activities inside, outside of the building. This summer holiday looked like that. Crafts, quilling, people with masks, or kids had storytelling hour online, or we could buy a tent and spread it in library's yard. This tent was very useful actually for a lot of cultural activities we tried and we succeed in a little part to do this year. Maybe we, of course, are a lot of things we can't do now, but we have to adapt, we have to be flexible. So we maybe should be the advantage of disadvantage. No space barters for online activities. We don't need time spent for arrive to library. Our users don't have to spend time for being a cars in the meeting or on C++ lessons. If we have less drive, is less paper consumed, more front money friendly. Small groups, if we have activities in the library, in our spaces, we must have small groups, but maybe they have a better knowledge. We are reinventing and reconfiguration the education projects for online. We are forced to learn new apps, increasing the long life learning process. Learning was never a crime. So we are learning to be the same open library online and in the physical way. Being forced to communicate with each other more and to learn together, we can communicate in a lot of ways. Creating stronger teams in front of danger, being a danger and maybe everybody felt a few of fear. So we are forced to be more together. New method that we use must activate active to people and offer technical support. Our volunteer can offer support for old people if it's possible on telephone, or if not, they had a meet one-to-one, keeping the social distance. This in an example, celebrating the Day of Seniors with our partner, the Center of Seniors Number 1 of Cluj-Napoca. Last year, we had a lot of people. We made a quiz on paper, but this year we can do a quiz online on quizzes. Last year we celebrate seniors with reading the books, some recommended books. But this year we met online. The public, but even librarians don't want to give up. Human library last year and this year we had the topic of living problems. Last year the number 5 of objective were in our room, a lot of people could meet. Robotics last year looked like that, more close. Here is the distance, but they having a big space is very important. The space, they can keep the distance and be here too. But if we could more than 10 people, this wouldn't be possible, and we had to do would have to do this on Zoom.
Anca, sorry, your 10 minutes are off. I don't want to interrupt you if you have how many slides do you have?
If you could say more loud, I didn't hear.
I said that we have to give the word to the other panelists because we have to stick on 50 minutes. But we have an image on how you managed to transform your library on that third place for the community. So if you only want to have, if you have a conclusion.
A conclusion, we have to transform, to adapt and to be the furthest space for community, offering technical support, being online, and keeping on touch even the physical meetings are not allowed.
Thank you very much, Anne.
Thank you too. Now we're almost finished.
Yes, I'm sorry, but we are many, and we will have Q&A, and maybe you can say some things then. I'm sure the participants will have questions, but the pictures you showed us are relevant. How you managed to do things this time. So now I ask Alina Calanicola to share with us the experience from the county library of Vâlcea.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm very glad to be here with you today, sharing a cup of coffee, and beautiful stories about libraries and communities, about the way that public library helps the community to grow, to become stronger, and to build, let's say, a better future for all the citizens. So in the next 10 minutes, I will present you a few of the projects that the library I work for, Vâlcea County Library, has developed. And it's still running, not only to satisfy, let's say, the specific needs of the local community, but also to show that we are an active part of this community, playing a valuable role, and to show that we care about all the people in the community, and we are more than happy to help them by providing trusted spaces that are free to enter and open to everyone, and they can explore and sharing reading or knowledge, culture, informations. Before I start the presentation, I have to tell you that the only criterion that I had in mind when I prepared this presentation was to show you many and different ways in which public library is involved in building a community. So now I will try to share my screen. I hope you are seeing the presentation. It's okay?
It's okay.
Okay, now let's do full screen. Okay. So this image I used for opening the presentation represents a piece of the library's roof shaped as stained glass dome. And I'm proud to say that recently it sets the world record for being the world's largest stained dome glass, according to the World Record Academy. And now coming back to our story. Okay. Let's say that it began in 2008 because until then we just thought that we knew the local community and we could satisfy people's need by knowing their reading preferences and their expectations regarding the different types of cultural event, let's say exhibitions or book launches or concerts. But in 2008, as I said, we found out that there are many other things, many other opportunities of helping the community. And Let's say we had the revelation when Vâlcea County Library became the first public library in Romania hosting an Europe Direct Information Center, which is a project founded by European Commission and the public library, public local authority, Vâlcea County Council. And the mission of this information center is to provide access to information on European institutions, policies, priorities, rights and responsibilities of European citizens. But this was the beginning because due to this project, we start the collaboration with local NGOs and we learned that together in partnership we found out more about the community needs and issues, and if that we can't always solve the problems or the issues, at least we can improve things or we can draw attention on them. And maybe one of the most important things that for our library that we created and developed this network of volunteers that includes youngsters with ages between 15 and 18. And they are involved not only in the activities of the Europe Direct Center, but also in the library's activities. Here are some examples of actions organized by our library in partnership with local NGOs in 2008. The Public Library and Civil Society was an interactive meeting about the importance of the role played by the woman in society. In 2009, If You Don't Vote, Don't Complain, it was an information session regarding parliamentary elections. Then between 2010-2014, we organized different courses dedicated to NGOs on how to write projects in order to get the funds from European Union or other funding bodies. Between 2008 and also in present, the network volunteers collect and donate food for people in need. So we organized charity events in order to promote the solidarity between generations and the tolerance for those with financial problems. Then another essential project in strengthening the partnership with the local NGOs for the benefit of the local community, of course, was the third space for active citizenship. And I could say that it was an unique project because it connected two worlds that until then had only intersected in passing. It was civil society and public libraries. And briefly, we arranged and transformed a space from the library into a meeting place for NGOs, and it seems that we did a great job because until the COVID pandemic came, this space was always full and served for numerous debates, exchanges of ideas, and planning various actions with the benefits for the local community. And I will give you some examples just to see, as I told you before, the diversity of these actions. It was here a school of parents about health and social contribution. There were workshops organized by a group of parents. Also, Youth on Move Association organized workshops in Erasmus Plus projects, or a working meeting with volunteers from EVS, European Voluntary Service. And I have to tell you that we involved these volunteers in different actions and events organized by our library. World Vision Romania Foundation also come here in the library and organize workshop for educational activities on personal development. Friends of Vâlcea Hospital Association organized Breastfeeding Week, a series of debates, presentation, just to increase the awareness on the importance of the breastfeeding for the health of the child. And so on. Red Cross, Provaldor Association, Down Vâlcea Association. And I will stop now because I think you get the idea of how changed this project, the library's life and the strong connections that it created with and for the local community. Code Kids, Children Are Coding in Public Libraries. It was a project that we started in 2017. It involves rural libraries from our county because just like us, they are working to improve and develop their small communities. And it's implemented with the support of the Progress Foundation, and it offers big opportunities to the children aged between 10 and 14 who are encouraged to actively engage or to follow a career in technology. And more precisely, we created coding clubs in the libraries where the passionate children in programming or electronic games, apps, and so on meet and learn developing coding and STEM skills. And here I selected some images from our three science fairs that our library organized, just to see the creativity and the outstanding results of these children. I also insert in the presentation a short video, but I don't know if the time is enough to play.
No, but maybe you will share it with us.
I can, yes, of course. I can share the link with you in the chat.
One more minute.
Okay. Then I will talk to you a little about the Romanian Cultural Center Saint Antimi Viranu from Parla that we founded in 2018. Parla is a small town situated at about 20 kilometers in the southern part of Madrid. And it was a project founded by the Ministry of Romanian for all Romanians in the world with the support of our local authority, Vâlcea County Council. That project as you see, it was dedicated to celebrate the centenary of the Great Union in 1918 and provides the Romanian inhabitants of the Madrid region a library with a fund of at least of let's say there were 10,000 then maybe in the in these 2 years that passed, I think the fund is about 14,000 volumes. And also they have the technology necessary for communication, laptop with the camera and so on. And the center's activities are focusing more on preserving, developing and asserting the cultural, ethnic, religious, and linguistic identity of Romanians in Spain. Here are some images from the official opening of the center and the organization. Also, we are running various projects to encourage reading for pleasure as an activity, a loisir activity from the small age until adults. And I will mention a few of them. Reading Together Romania, a national project, Book Eaters, where high school students met in the library and debated the title recommended by the librarian, Read for the Record, an international campaign. when millions of children and adults are around the world are reading the same book in the same day, just to get a record. Also, CITIM in Romania is the acronym from reading together. We transform hearts and minds. Librarians are we're going to schools and take interactive reading hours. And we even founded a street library in 2018 with the support of the local authorities, where people can borrow books without having to return them, and also can donate by simply leaving it on the shelves. Besides this, our library has developed and still running solid partnerships with European NGOs as a result of numerous projects, and I would mention it here only two ongoing projects, and there are innovative projects. Visual Library of Cultural Heritage, it's a project that initiates specific actions to empower adult participants with the skills needed to create a visual library, which gather together the most relevant pieces of cultural heritage from 8 European countries. And it's a new method that will highlight the cultural heritage, and we'll introduce new learning tools based on augmented reality. And I put here the link to the project site. And also we have another innovative project developing AR resources in youth offender learning. It's a project that introduces, develops, and roll out the use of augmented reality to youth offender learnings. We have four key partners that create AR resources, like posters, worksheets, and learning cards. And these tools will be delivered to the prison staff and to the offenders like an interactive learning, you know, education. And for more information, I put there the link. And because we all are living difficult times caused by this COVID-19 pandemic, I will end the presentation and the story about libraries and the local communities' growth through projects by sharing with you a new social action that our library, with a new partner, Valcea Community Foundation, will start soon. It's called Taking Care of Yourself. You will take care of everyone else. And it aims to its aim is to increase awareness on the importance of knowing and respecting the rules and the practical measures for the safety of every child during COVID-19 pandemic. And how we will try to do this, we will organize workshops in a ludic manner, just to teach the children the rules of conduct during COVID-19 pandemic. And this social action is the first one from a wide range of actions that will take place in order to increase awareness regarding the importance of the health education, because the COVID-19 pandemic showed us how vulnerable we are. And how can simple measures prevent the contamination with the virus? So we want to take the first step in starting the health of education of the local community. And our approach will be according to the principle that it is easier to prevent than to treat.
Thank you, Alina.
Thank you. As a conclusion, I want to say just a few seconds that I think the public libraries in these times, they have to stay close to the community. It's important to continue to be here and help the community with everything we can. Thank you.
Thank you. I noted something you have in common. You both, you and the first presentation were about volunteer programs. This mm-hmm. is the one thing I noted, one conclusion. I like very much, and I want to emphasize that search space for active citizenship, because as you said, the library is a trusted space. Mm-hmm. In both presentations, I saw that you attract community to come and do things in the library, but you also go out in the community. So these are the few conclusions and things you have in common in your project. Mm-hmm. Now I would like to invite Ovidiu. Please be short. Stay in.
Okay. Thank you, Ruxandra. Thank you all. I'm happy to be here with you and to discuss about this topic, because for our organization, it's very important to share our experience and to show you our success stories, and to increase the number of projects for communities through libraries. Progress Foundation has a long history in terms of projects in collaboration with public libraries. And I'm very happy to see in Alina presentation that a few projects of Progress Foundation. Third space of active citizenship, or code kids, ora să știm. And in our portfolio, we have another few projects that have innovative ideas and very interesting partnerships. Because when we develop a project, we collaborate with international partners, and in our between our project, we will discuss about New Leap, a very good project based on human design thinking methodology developed with Aarhus Library. And implemented in Romania with a public library from Ploiești, county public library from Ploiești, where we develop a new space based on design thinking. Also, we had developed projects on digital storytelling methodology. And I think a lot of public libraries from Romania took this methodology and developed new services in their libraries. And I think the example, I can show you more examples, but I want to answer to the question about challenges and how an NGO can collaborate with public libraries, because from Alina and Anca, you seen only the results and the good ideas, but for an NGO, it's very hard to work with public libraries, because we want. First of all, we must convince the libraries that the project or idea is good for their community and is correlated with their mission. Our work with public libraries in Romania started in 2008 in the BiblioNet program, because apart from our team working Biblionet program, and starting with that times, we come with computers. We put computers in public libraries. It was a challenge to change the shift, mental shift, to have this mental shift between the libraries, a space of books, and the libraries, a space of information and new technologies. After that, we develop a very good development program, and we train the librarians in new services for communities. And based on that training, a lot of librarians from Romania start to develop innovative services based on community needs. And in 2014, we come with another innovative idea to create spaces for active citizenship. It was very hard to present this idea for many county libraries, because a lot of county libraries are connected with local council and is connected with politicians. And we had a challenge to not be seen so well, because the politician don't want to see active citizen in their spaces, because it can be a challenge for them. And we present this project to our partners, and they start to create a new speech for their patrons, and also to collaborate with local NGOs and with the public on this team. I think the success of third space of active citizenship were the fact that a lot of NGOs start to collaborate with public libraries. And a lot of people come in the new spaces and start to discuss about new terms in public libraries, as a democracy or sexuality or rule of law, themes that in the past we didn't found in the public library. This project continued, ended in 2016, but now we start to develop it in other countries, in Moldova or Ukraine. And we have a big success there, because they start to develop active citizen space in the library, and they start to collaborate with NGOs and new public. And I think a lot of partners are here and participate to this discussion. The other projects of Project Foundation are based on innovation, new team terms, or based on how to attract new publics in public library and how to develop the local communities through public libraries. When we set up this mission of our organization, we start to think projects based on public libraries strategies and based on good examples from more developed public libraries from Europe or USA. So, returning to our challenges, I want to say we'll have this kind of challenges based on our cultural specific, because the public libraries are connected with the public system, and we will find their distrust, or we'll have there a lot of bureaucracy, and the solution are very often connected with money, and the public libraries don't have a big budget for new project and to develop new ideas. But with trust and with a good communication with them, will you will create good project, and for sure will find the public that needs our input. Because now in Code Kids project, we work with kids from rural area, and we train them on digital skills. We develop digital their digital skills, and I think in this moment we see how important it is to have this kind of skills, and I'm very happy to have the public libraries as a partner, and to put the public libraries as an important actor who develop digital skills in their community under the serve community, because a lot of libraries work with underserved public, not with rich people and very educated person.
Yes, it's very interesting. I was thinking now maybe these skills are contagious, and maybe librarian will be contaminated by what's happening in the libraries in terms of digital skills.
Yeah, we try to communicate about this project and to show to all Romanian librarians that this project it's a project with impact, and the kids who come in our project learn a lot of things and very useful things. I think a lot of kids from our project teach the teachers how to use the online platforms or how to keep online course, and for me this is a successful story of the Romanian libraries.
Yeah, but I would like to come back and emphasize an interesting thing you shared with us. And it seems to me that you, the civil society, are a link between the public libraries, and you are thinking at the public library as a vector of the public system in general. You said that.
Yes.
In other words, and a link between the public system and the community. And the meeting point is in the library.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so this is, we have a point of view from another angle than our colleagues in the libraries. But we, as much as we want to change the mindset and to work differently. At the end of the day, we are public institutions. So the mindset needs to be changed at a higher level. So maybe Ioana, if you are here,
yes,
share with us some ideas. I know you will have interesting things to say about this. Thank you.
Thank you for introducing me, Ruxandra. Hello, everyone. First of all, I'm glad to be here today and to be part of this dialogue, inspiring dialogue with our colleagues from libraries, representatives from NGOs, but also some professionals from abroad, in order to find out how public libraries can deal with the pandemic in the best possible way and with the most creative means, if it's possible. As our work becomes more and more connected to digital, and activities, meetings, and collaborations move into online amid of the global pandemic, public libraries need to adapt to a new way of working and rethink their role and mission in empowering users to use digital. From the point of view of our association, the National Association of Public Librarians and Libraries in Romania, as the most representative association of libraries at the national level, it is more important than ever for libraries to intervene in a structured and combined way in the process of knowledge sharing to make them easier to understand. During this COVID pandemic, our major concern is how to keep our librarian members involved and optimistic in a time when our work circumstances have become very difficult and sometimes unpredictable. An extremely offering method in which AMBPR manages to keep the library network united and motivated, despite the restrictive conditions caused by COVID-19, is the development and implementation of projects in supporting communities. In order to give all of you an overview of the current project activity of AMBPR, I will present in the next few minutes some of the most recent and inspiring projects that are dedicated to the community and to the library service users at large. First of all, I will refer to the most recent project implemented by AMBPR. It's about Python. It's a project financed under the umbrella of Meet and Code initiative, and it's about the introducing vulnerable youngsters in using Python language as the most popular programming language of the future. Starting from the previous expertise of AMBPR in digital literacy, but also in initiating youngsters in the use of the latest coding languages, this intervention our Python course consisted in providing a Python online course for about 100 vulnerable youngsters. Our main aims were to explain the basic concepts of Python programming, to introduce the basic concepts of writing, compiling, and interpreting in Python. And last but not least, we propose to introduce vulnerable students in some methods to play successfully using the Python programming language.
Ioana, sorry, I have one question here.
Please.
Do you follow up after those courses? Do you know if the young people, the young students in your courses are using the knowledge in their career or something like this?
The Python course is very recent, and we didn't succeed to collect all the information about the results.
I see, but you have this component also?
Yes, we intend to involve these participants in a large series of interventions in digital environment, including another very recent online course. Is about a course that is in progress right now. It's about JavaScript project financed under the umbrella of Google Europe Code Week. This course will be finalized today in the evening. The title of this new project is Web Mentor, JavaScript and Web Design for Beginners. And this online training aims to initiate young people in creating, coding, and adapting the visual identity of websites and web different web application using the JavaScript language. This most recent online training is addressed to high school students aged 14, 18, interested in coding and web design. And our main goal was to familiarize them with the general syntax, general grammar of programming, and the basic use of JavaScript principles and concepts. And in between these two projects, there are some links, because part of our participants from the first course came back as students in the new project initiative, the last one about JavaScript. On the other hand, AMBPR had a very, very intense activity in terms of projects. A few months ago, AMBPR had a quality of partner in another important project financed within Erasmus Plus program. It's about Teach for Future. This project is a strategic partnership implemented in three countries, Romania, Bulgaria, and Greece. And the main aim of this project is transformative education of adults through innovation, technology, and entrepreneurship. And I want to say that the National Library of Romania is our associate partner in this large project. And we are very honored having you as a partner. Another important project addressed to community was Safe Community Inspire Gymnasium Students to Become Entrepreneurs. It's an initiative of AMBPR financed by the US Embassy, State Department, and this project was focused on teaching social entrepreneurship in rural areas in Alba and Bistrița counties.
Ioana,
please.
Thank you too. Yes, but because I would like also to emphasize a few things. Also, in common with the previous presentations, which is focusing on developing digital skills, and I have in mind a subject for another future presentation, because we develop digital skills, we learn young people and not only to use the internet, but I'm thinking about the intellectual rights why using digital content. So maybe we will do another meeting on this subject. You mentioned the center in the National Library. Thank you for coming here with this opportunity. And I would like to say that we want to take it to the next level because we are part in a digital innovation hub. And we hope to be between 12 hubs selected at national level and proposed to European Commission, and that we will manage to develop projects together after 2021. So, finger crossed. And now I would like to introduce Maria Kovac. Are you here?
Yes, I am. Hello. Good morning, everyone. May I say that I am not from Volum Foundation Federation. Sorry, I'm from New Horizons Foundation, which is a member, in fact, of Volum Federation. But I'm not here to represent the whole Volum, only our foundation. As Ovidiu also said, obviously we are beneficiaries of some of the services that public libraries so generously share, namely space. But our foundation has also worked with librarians from public libraries, mostly in rural areas, small cities, small towns, and engage them as volunteers, in fact, generally alongside with teachers. And these librarians alongside teachers acted as, or act, still act, as impact club leaders. Impact clubs are extracurricular activities, clubs for students. And they meet on a weekly basis and implement so-called service learning projects. And librarians, some of them in the places where we work, prove to be very dedicated volunteer impact club leaders. But I think the main reason why I'm here today is to look at the future in a way. And I would like to share a non-public library resource, but since you were talking about digital skills, well, we all know that this year actually was not a very good one for anyone, for schools in particularly not a good one. Before the pandemic started, we had planned to run a project which involved summer schools built around trade books that children would read with teachers and do a lot of activities for 10 days based or starting from these children's books, illustrated children's books, so starting from reading. But as the lockdown came, we found ourselves a bit limited, obviously, in moving around. And we thought, why not use this time to produce some resources which can be shared online. And in this way, we came across a private online library, which is open access, and all the books there are open access and made by volunteer illustrators and writers, called Bookdash. And they are generous enough to allow translation into any language of their books. So what we did was we worked with volunteers. We identified dozens of volunteers and translated children's books. Children's books which are illustrated and which are quite short and which are grouped by levels. As you can see, there are four levels of books that we share. There are 100 titles approximately, a bit more, but we are intending to grow with this. But the main reason why I'm sharing this with you is because in connection with these books and in connection with our lessons learned this summer, we want to expand our program and we want to have such summer schools, which are in fact focusing on improving children's literacy skills, early literacy skills. So we would want to have more libraries involved here. And as you may see now, we have put together a guidebook for such summer school organizers. And I think librarians, if not on their own, at least with schools, could do a great job here. And we also put together a curriculum for these summer schools. I mentioned they were built around 10 trade books, illustrated trade books. Obviously, those 10 books can change. And I again see a role for librarians here in suggesting children's books which are appropriate to be read aloud with groups of children and then build ensuing activities on these stories. Unfortunately, this summer, we did not directly contact any libraries. The summer schools took place in rural areas in Cluj, in five villages, and none of them has a good local library. Unfortunately, as you may know, schools also don't have good libraries, so school libraries are also poor. What we did was obviously donated as many books as we could, helped schools put together small libraries, and obviously also promoted this online library because it can provide resources for children who could not go and borrow such books, appropriate level books for them to practice reading from local libraries.
Sorry, so, I have a question here.
Yes,
sorry,
please.
Maria, just a question about this online library. How you manage the intellectual property on the content of the books? Are they under rights? How you did this? It's a challenge.
I am truly sorry. I couldn't hear you.
I asked about the online library. You hear me now? Do you hear me, Maria? I will write the question on the chat. Sorry, Maria, are you still here?
I am here now, but for some reason I don't know, maybe my signal wasn't strong enough.
Okay.
I'm here
now,
yeah. I
was prepared to write you on the chat. I asked about the online library you mentioned, and
yes.
I suppose you gave access to books there for
yes.
certain groups. How you managed
yes.
to do this and be compliant with the intellectual property?
Well, the sites where we got these books from have open access Creative Commons licenses. So as I was saying, it's initiatives from abroad. One of them is from South Africa. The other one mostly from India. So all sorts of, but also under UNESCO, all sorts of open access books, which can be downloaded, translated, read, spread, disseminated, and absolutely generous on the part of the people who put together this library, clearly to supplement the quality of books that are available for young children, for beginner readers, in libraries, and not only in libraries, but also, you know, if parents wanted to buy such books, they could. The target population that we have in mind would not be able to afford such books. So I point it out because if you look at the site, it's I put the address in the chat. You will see that they are culturally very little relevant for Romania. So it's quite clear that the illustrators are not from Romania or from Europe for that matter. But we think this is a start, and we are also hoping to inspire local authors, illustrators to look at children's books from the perspective
yeah.
of also helping them read. So think of beginner readers, not just
yeah.
nice stories, but think of beginner readers. And I just want to emphasize that libraries, public libraries, have a crucial role in helping children develop literacy skills, early literacy skills. And I think when it comes to bridging the community, well, libraries and schools and such, it's a huge need for schools and libraries to work together for children's literacy skills, at least basic literacy skills. Children who don't have a good start in their family, who don't have books in their, who don't grow up with books, with parents who read, will be affected for a lifetime. It's hard to overcome that, that delay. I mean, what you miss out on in a childhood without books, without stories, it's almost impossible for schools to make up for. So here's a call to public librarians as promoters and champions of literacy, and clearly partners of teachers and schools. Thank you.
Because a conclusion and also an idea that came to me while you are speaking. We discussed a lot about volunteering, and you emphasized the importance of using young kids as little as possible to reading. One of the challenges here is to have as many books as possible open source, with open access, which is very hard. And maybe we can gather some illustrators and book writers who open access to be used to develop reading skills for young people and to attract them to reading.
Yes.
Yeah, and maybe all of us who are here together can think about it, and maybe a project will come from here.
I know for a fact that Cluj County Library has had a number of initiatives in which they reached out to families with young children, and including babies, yeah, and started such.
We saw local and or national or even European initiatives, but together we can take it to another level.
Absolutely.
We need to be more in this to see the effect. Yeah. They are needed these days. This is one of the challenges as far as I see. So we have all our five panelists presenting their projects, and thank you again. We saw also some questions. Claudia, you wrote to them on chat, and they came out from the discussions. I think that we have best practices, but I also think that each of us wants more from the other partner. A public library wants something from the civil society, and the civil society has an image of a public library as a partner, and this image is not the one they are meeting in reality. So we have to discuss more, but maybe we will not finish the subject. The subject will stay open for other discussions. Now I'm taking this opportunity. I gave you two directions, and please come with questions. So the Q&A session.
So the way to do this, it's actually in two ways, depending on the level of your courage and your time. So you can either write your question in the chat, and then Ruxandra and or me or Claudia, some of the hosts will come with the question and read it for the panelists, so that you get your answer. Or you can actually ask for, you can unmute your microphone and your camera and just address the question. Before doing that, just while you are gathering your courage and zip the last, of your coffee, I will also tell you that we do need feedback on the way we organize meetings. So I will leave a feedback form as a link in this chat. Well, when you have 2 minutes, please don't forget about it, because we want to do better. This is part of a series of online meetings that we are doing. So that means that we want to be better and better when we continue with our series. So this is the link, and please don't be shy about questions. You can write it down or just pop up on the screen and then use your voice. So who wants to go first from the panelists? I cannot hear you very well, Ruxandra, so maybe you can...
Maybe we will bring with the questions. does a good partner library look like? And how does a good NGO partner look like? We need volunteers to answer.
I see a video bringing up his answer.
Yes.
Okay.
I want to answer to the how good library partners look like. From my point of view, a good partner in our projects is a library which are ready to develop the project and to transform the project in a library service. This is the first aspect, because when we develop a project, we think to the sustainability of the project, and our ideas are connected with library, because the library are there in the communities and they are a point of the sustainability. The second one criteria is to have a good partner in terms of communication, because we are very open to discuss the agreement aspects and to be and to not have some surprise during the project implementation. And third aspect from my point of view is to offer time to learn and to innovate, because the projects are connected with learning and innovative ideas. Because of that, it's a project. And for that, you need time. Also, our team learn a lot of things during the project, and a lot of learning points are beside of our public library partners. And for that, the managers of county libraries must empower the project coordinators and to give them time to learn about the new project, the new ideas, and to implement the innovation in their libraries. I keep the my answer only on these three aspects.
The other question I would ask Anca and Alina to give an answer. What are they expecting from an NGO partner?
Okay, I will answer from my point of view. A good NGO partner for the public library has to be trustful, serious, has to know the community's needs, has to be open to dialogue, you know, when we decide to create a partnership, the public library with the NGO, I think we have to know what are the strengthness of each partner, you know, and to put it like specific I don't know tasks, and when we are together in a partnership, let's say both public library and NGO has to respect what it engaged to do, you know, and that's why I think the NGOs make a good team with the public libraries, because they are coming with their resources adding to the library's resources, even if it's about human resources or materials one, and the common aim is to help the community, I think, no matter what NGO we are talking.
Thank you, Alina. Anca?
I think a good NGOs is an organization who's intending to give a plus in the process of education and information of citizens in our area. And I don't think generally managers, directors are politically influenced. From my experience, when a library work with an organization, it's very important to be very clear the objectives, the goals, and what have to do every part. And if for the community is a good thing, is something to learn, something from a long learning process, and even recreating information, I think the public library will do everything it can to realize this.
So if I can also come back here with my voice, with and probably hopefully with no sound problem. Thank you for being with us, you know, and now we are over time. So if you like to stay, we would love to have you for a few more minutes. Don't forget that we want to be better. So please do the form. And if I can also say my opinion as me and Claudia, we are the ones that are both. We are librarians working in NGOs with libraries. So it's like a very inception type of role that we take. And we've seen a lot of libraries being so good partners for NGOs. And most of the times it starts with space. The NGO finds out, has this problem of having the great idea, a great idea for a project. They want to reach out to the community. Sometimes they know already how to do that, but they lack the resources, some of the resources, some of the most valuable resources being the space, the physical space, which is on pause, on break right now, but this is mostly the first step. And then they discover in that space that most of the libraries, that librarians that they interact with, not only that are good, but they are great, and they become friends and then become partners. So it's such a beautiful thing to see. It's one of the reasons why we Claudia, me, and Ovidiu and All Progress Foundation believes so much in this type of symbiosis, this type of coming together with resources between libraries and NGOs and civil society organizations, because we believe that it's a match made in heaven. We've seen it so many times from the outside and from the inside. Progress Foundation, almost all the projects that we implement, we do it like this. And I think that it's not only us in Romania, we know at least a few others that do the same, and we so much believe in this kind of formula that brings together resources from organizations and builds a great value in communities.